You can explore more of your favourite CBeebies shows on BBC iPlayer.
Did you know that the Earth is part of a special family? It's called the Solar System. And this family is made up of 8 very different planets. Order of the planets, starting from nearest the Sun, is Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune. What a fantastic family! What brings all these planets together is our nearest star, the Sun. Each planet follows its own path around the Sun, called an orbit. Even though there are 8 planets moving around at once, they never bump into each other. That is impressive. Some planets' orbits around the Sun are faster than others. The Earth only takes 1 year to orbit the Sun, but Neptune takes around 165 Earth years.
You can explore more of your favourite CBeebies shows on BBC iPlayer.
A year is divided into 4 seasons: spring, summer, autumn, and winter. Each season is about 3 months or 12 weeks long. You can notice the seasons changing by looking at the trees around you. In spring, they can have colourful blossoms and new leaves. In summer, all the branches are covered in lush green leaves. In autumn, the leaves change from green to oranges, reds, and browns and fall to the ground, leaving the tree bare of leaves for winter until the spring arrives again. You might also notice that the weather changes when the seasons change. Spring and summer are usually warmer, and autumn and winter are usually cooler. But why do the seasons change? It's to do with the way the Earth orbits or moves around the Sun, which takes a full year to complete. Planet Earth has an invisible line through it called an axis. When the Earth orbits around the Sun, it doesn't stand upright, it tilts on its axis. For part of the year, one half of the Earth, which is called a hemisphere, is closer to the Sun, meaning the seasons there are warmer. And for the other part of the year, that hemisphere is further away, so the seasons are cooler. So when it's summer in the northern hemisphere, on the other side of the planet in the southern hemisphere, it's winter. Gravity is an invisible force that pulls everything on Earth downwards. But gravity isn't just on Earth. It's a force that pulls two objects towards each other. Gravity is what holds the Earth and other planets in their paths or orbits around the Sun. And gravity is also what keeps the Moon in its orbit around the Earth. The bigger the mass of the object, that's how much matter or stuff it's made from, the stronger its force of gravity. Because the Earth has such a big mass, its force of gravity is really, really strong. So it is Earth's gravity that pulls everything on it down to the ground. Because humans have much less mass than the Earth, we don't really feel the force of gravity, so we can walk around on Earth quite easily. The Moon also has a smaller mass than Earth, so the force of gravity on the Moon is less than the force of gravity on Earth. So if you were ever on the Moon, you would feel much lighter if you tried to walk around on it. Shadows can be really fun. A shadow is the dark shape made when something blocks light from a light source like the Sun or a torch. That's because light travels in straight lines, so it can't go through an object or go around it. Where the light is blocked, a shadow is made of the same shape. The closer to the light source, the bigger the shadow. Sometimes shadows might look like one thing, but really, there's something else. Every sound you hear is made by vibrations. Whenever you hear something, it's because vibrations are traveling through the air and being picked up by your ears, which then pass that information to your brain. Your brain is really smart. It can interpret what different vibrations sound like. These vibrations are called sound waves. And if you were able to see them, they'd look a bit like this. The louder a sound is, the bigger the vibration it makes, which is shown by a bigger sound wave. The quieter a sound is, the smaller the vibration it makes, which is shown as a smaller sound wave. Pitch tells us how high or how low a sound is. The pitch of a sound depends on how fast or how slow the vibrations are. The faster the vibrations, the higher the pitch. and the slower the vibrations, the lower the pitch. So sound is made by vibrations. And it's why you're able to hear me say this sentence. And this one, and this one too.
You can explore more of your favourite CBeebies shows on BBC iPlayer.
Everything is made up of matter. Matter is another word for the stuff things are made from. Everything around us, everything you can see and touch, is made of matter. Anything that takes up space is called matter. Air, water, rocks, and even people are examples of matter. And how much matter something is made up of affects how heavy or light it will be. Scientists use the term mass to measure exactly how heavy or light an object is. You might think bigger objects are heavier and have a bigger mass than smaller ones because they're bigger in size, like this hippo. But that's not always true. Sometimes bigger objects can have less mass than smaller objects, like this balloon and this banana, for instance. The balloon is full of air, so it actually has less mass than the banana. Buoyancy is an object's ability to float in water or air. When you put an object in water, it pushes some of that water out of the way. This is called displacement. But the displaced water always tries to push back to where it was. This force is called upthrust. And it means an object in water has two forces working on it. The force of gravity, which is the weight of the object pushing down, and upthrust, force of the water pushing up. An object like a snooker ball is dense. This is because the material and particles it is made from are tightly packed together. Because it is so dense, the effect of gravity is greater than the upthrust, so it sinks. It is not buoyant. A football is less dense because it's filled with air. The effect of gravity is less than the upthrust, so it floats. It is buoyant. But what about a ship? It's huge and heavy, but because it's hollow and mostly full of air, the force of all that displaced water pushing up, the upthrust, is much stronger than the force of gravity pushing down. A force might seem like something very mysterious and magical, but a force can be simply a push or a pull. Sometimes, forces can cause an object to move. And sometimes forces slow, stop, or change the direction of an object's movement. We can't actually see a force, but we can see what it does, like the force of the wind blowing and pushing leaves. It can be the force of pushing or pulling on dough or modelling clay and changing its shape. It can be the force of kicking a ball when the foot pushes it away. Even a wall can redirect a force and push the ball back. A force can even be something as simple as pulling or pushing to open a door. Have you ever wondered how magnets stay on a fridge? It's because of an invisible force called magnetism. A magnet is an object that has a magnetic field, and that magnetic field either attracts or repels other magnetic objects, like the metal these items are made of. The two ends of a magnet are called poles, and each magnet has a north pole and a south pole, just like planet Earth. Opposite ends of magnets attract, so the north pole of one magnet attracts the south pole of another magnet. But the same sides of magnets push away or repel, so the north pole of one magnet pushes away the north pole of another magnet, and the south pole pushes away the south pole of the other. Magnetic materials are always made of metal, but not all metals are magnetic. For example, gold isn't magnetic. Colours are everywhere. There are lots of important colours that we can mix together to make a huge range of different colours. Here are red, yellow, and blue. These are called primary colours. When we mix red and yellow together, we make orange. When we mix red and blue together, we make purple. And when we mix blue and yellow together, we make green. Orange, purple, and green are secondary colours made from mixing different combinations of our primary colours, red, yellow, and blue. So many beautiful colours.
Do you love CBeebies? Well, you can learn, sing, and explore with all your favourite CBeebies friends, like Number Blocks, Mr. Tumble, Bluey, Jojo and Gran-Gran, and so much more. Why not ask your grown-up to download the BBC iPlayer app, where you can watch all your favourite CBeebies friends anytime, anywhere you like.